Valencia!
What it do?
How are you, beautiful? I'm glad you took your shades off because you were shaving me, okay? How are you, beautiful? What's going on?
I'm good. Everything's good. Glad to be with you.
Well, you look good. This space is done. Are you in Chicago? Are you somewhere? You like you out of town somewhere. Are you all right?
I am in Chicago quarantining. I'm at home.
Yes, yes, yes. Well, you guys, I thank you guys for tuning in. You guys know who I am. I am Brandon Moment, better known as Style Me Brandon. You guys know you can find me on all social media platforms at Style Me Brandon. My website is www.stylemebrandon.com. You guys know what I'm doing. This is client talk, you guys. I'm just coming on with friends, clients, colleagues, everyone. Okay, let me position my seat correctly. Can you guys see me? Can you see me, Valencia?
I can.
Oh, because on my screen over here, it wasn't correct. Okay, so you guys are good. All right, so you guys know, I'm just coming on as client talk. And basically what I'm doing is I am just talking about fashion with clients, with my colleagues. I'm bringing on everyone that is fashionable. Like you guys know, Valencia is the goat of praise and worship. As you guys can see her right now, she is fashionista. That is enough about me, guys. I want you guys to know who this beautiful treasure that we have on here, Valencia. For those that don't know who you are, do you mind telling the people a brief introduction of who you are, what you do, and just what you are about?
Well, my name is Valencia Lacey. I am a worship leader. I am the pastor of the Altar Church of Worship, School of Worship, where it's a different type of church. It's not traditional. It's non-traditional. It's actually a place where we just praise and we just worship God. It's for minstrels and for dancers, ministers of music, movement. It's for anybody that's in the music ministry to come and just woosah to relax and to get in the presence of God. If we're always responsible for the worship, then, you know, when do we actually get to worship? So the altar is that place that God gave me vision for over 10 years ago. So basically that's what I was a former hairstylist. What else you want to know? I was born and raised in the Apostolic Church. Hallelujah. What else? I write different things like that, you know. And I was formerly a part of Shekinah Glory. And that's a ministry that's always blessed me. And I hope it's blessed you guys too. So, yeah, that's about it.
You guys.
You want more?
I got to go to praise and worship on here with me today. You guys, she going to tell y'all because she believes she is fashionista. So we're going to talk about that. We're going to get into that. But this conversation is going to be all about fashion pertaining to worship. So you guys know Valencia is the goat of praise and worship. You guys have saw her all over the world. This is the lady that told the world, don't clap, lift your hands. On the BET Network, as she was ministering, yes, she told the people, don't clap, sex, lift your hands. Tell me that ain't no true worship. Yeah. And Valencia, we applaud you. We applaud you. We applaud you. Because listen, worship wouldn't have hit Chicago, not only Chicago, the world, if we didn't have a sea and a vessel like yourself. So I want to personally thank you for your work that you have done for the gospel industry.
Thank you. You've been doing your little research too. Thank you. Thank you. To God be the glory.
Yes.
To God be
so
the glory.
So, Valencia, you gave fun facts, but let's step outside of the church in your industry to worship. Can you give the people two fun facts about you?
Ooh, two fun facts about me. I guess one is that I drive with my feet crossed. It's very comfortable. So yeah, I drive with my feet crossed. And what else? I think it's something funny that I cannot stand to see chewed up gum anywhere, like when people put on their plates or any. It just tears me up to see chewed up gum. It'll just make me, I don't know. Yeah, that's a fact though.
Well, if we gonna go with the chew up gum, first of all, I'll piggyback on the driving with the feet crossed. Baby, she's so comfortable driving with her feet crossed because Valencia doesn't get on the expressway, you guys.
Don't be telling my business, friend. I don't need the whole world knowing. I like to be comfortable and take my time and go and drive home with my children. We watch the DVD and we're good. We're good.
Yeah. But you guys, this is good. This is good, you guys. So you guys that's just tuning in, you guys, thank you for your reactions. I know you guys are not giving me reactions. You guys are giving the go, the praise, and worship reactions. And I thank them. Thank you guys for them. Please keep them coming, you guys. I got the one and only Valencia Lakes on here with me, you guys. Come on, share. For those that are on praise team, one of y'all on praise team, she gonna tell y'all how y'all supposed to look, okay? And I'm gonna tell her, well, Valencia, that's a little harsh, but we gonna get through this thing, okay? But Valencia, the first question, are you ready to jump on this? Are you ready to get on this train? Are you ready?
Yeah, I didn't see the comments, so I was saying I wanted to say hi to everybody, Joy and Merrick and who else
Joy,
on there,
hey.
And Mark, my nephew Marquise, and my daughter Char Chantel. Just want to say hey, I'm ready whenever
you. And
want.
Another fun fact that you left out: you are a parent.
I am a parent. I'm somebody's mama.
Yes, you are.
Yeah, I have to.
Because they finna take over this lab in a second.
Honey, they might not let me be great. I'm about to slip off. Yeah. But yes, I have two babies. I have an 8-month-old and a 2-year-old. So let's pray
wow.
And let me be great. Let me be great for a minute.
Like her, y'all. They look
like my kids look like me. They do.
Yes. So Valencia, let's jump into the first question. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, Valencia, in the industry that you are a part of, is fashion important and why?
Well, the role that praise and worship is taking today, your presentation is definitely important, especially if you're going to be an artist. Especially since we're in this pandemic where your media presence needs to be up to par. It's also inviting to people when you are well presented, when you are put together well, and you are attractive. You know, let's be honest. The world is consumed with attractive people. So so yeah, your presentation is very important. Yeah, you want to get their attention definitely.
So you guys hear it. So you guys hear it, even in praise and worship, that's what opened the service. For those that are old like myself, you remember devotion, you know, Jesus on the main line, tell him what you want, oh, Jesus on the main line, tell him what you want. But now, the church has expanded, and now we come out and we say, great is the Lord, greatly to be praised, great is the Lord, greatly to be praised. So that's what we're doing now. So in the midst of doing that, your deacons had on the walking suits, but now we are in praise and worship. And you got to make it make sense. And fashion is really, really important. And so you guys heard it from the go to praise and worship in the industry that she is in. Appearance is important. So the next question is for you, because everyone is not who you are. Is there a dress code for a praise and worship leader?
Absolutely, especially for me. Now, I don't know about most praise and worship leaders, but we're quite active on stage. And I've done the whole high heel thing and trying to have the whole put together look, but nothing fashion, nothing and nobody interferes with my worship. So if it's a hindrance, I'm not going to wear it. So we do what we call is we wear worship-friendly clothing, meaning that you're able to be comfortable and still worship. So for me, there are no high heels anymore, none of that stuff. I'm not trying to impress anybody. Most of the time, I have April Shannon. She'll make me skirts that are to the floor. that I can avoid wearing heels. So if y'all see me in these skirts, it's not because I think it's so cute. It's because I'm not wearing high heels. So I'm wearing a comfortable shoe so I can jump and I can worship anything. Now, I got some worship leaders under me that, honey, they live with a heel. Nothing I can do with them. They want their heels on. And they be up there tripping and slinging them off when they get excited. Do you, boo?
Valencia.
Yeah. Oh, honey, yeah. They done all been disobedient and tripped over them heels and then 5 inches and stuff. It looks cute, but it gets in the way of your worship. So there are only a few professional heel wearers that I know that can really be active in worship and still be okay and have their balance. But for the most part, we want to try to keep things where you can worship and still look nice, you know. And that is not just about high heels. It's about the fabrics you wear also. I have nothing against people that wear their clothes fitted. I have nothing against those who are well put together, or even those who are endowed. My issue with people and their fashions are the fabrics they choose. If you're jiggling, if your endowment is moving more than, you know, everything else on you, then that's where the problem comes in that. So if you're going to wear it, wear a secure fabric like denim or something that's going to hold you where you're not shaking and where you're not a distraction. Yeah.
So you guys, you hear that. You guys that's worship leaders, you guys are that's at those storefront churches or at those mega churches. Honey, sometimes you can leave that heel and get you a long skirt. What's her name again, the one that makes them for you?
April Shannon makes my long
April Shannon. So April Shannon, yeah. I'm giving you a plug, so make sure you share my video, sweetheart. So, you know, she gets April Shannon, when you praise and worship leaders, that, you know, it's just y'all be tripping when y'all be, you know, doing what y'all be doing. Because if I start quoting ad-libs, y'all gonna know who I'm talking about. So, you know, but y'all, for those that be doing it, you know, just let's all make it make sense, if that's all right, okay?
Yeah.
So, there is a dress code for a praise and worship leader, VF, if you are a male or female, correct?
Oh, absolutely. Men, you have to be careful with exposing your genitalia, because that's a distraction also. Wearing pants that are too tight and things like that. If people are more consumed with what you have on than the actual worship, then you're failing. We don't want to fail at the worship. We want to make sure that we look nice, but we're not distracting anybody in any way. So that goes for men too, with tight pants and the gray jogging pants. Listen, first, let's be very clear. There are going to be people in the audience that are going to be attracted to you just because you're anointed, or just because you're platformed. So we have to be careful that we're not on stage trying to be on the market. We are not on the market doing worship. We are there to worship and live God. A window is cutting up on this live. I'm laughing at his comments. But we are not on the market. You're not up there to get your man or get your woman, you know? The anointing is attractive with or without your clothing. So if there's somebody that wants to talk to you or be with you, that's going to shine through regardless. But to go on stage to be, you know, noticed or seen, that's the wrong motivation. So we want to make sure that when we're going up, we're going up for the right reasons. So when you're choosing your attire, choose things that look nice, but make sure you're not taking the shine off God. Because, you know, if he's not present, you're not going to be successful anyway.
So, you guys,
across the room.
She's not only a worship leader. She's flowing well, because she had knocked out about 3 of my questions. So the spirit that hit her. So the spirit is trying to tell her, baby, she got to put her kids to sleep for their nap. So you flowing.
Baby, this little girl done threw some across the room already. Wendy like, who you fucking?
God, sir. So listen, you guys, so male, female, so you females, you know, you shouldn't be tripping over heels. You shouldn't be tripping over your hair. You shouldn't be tripping over your earrings. None of that. Men, you guys, the Lord has blessed some of us. That is not for worship, okay? The worship, baby, the people out there, you don't know what happened. Like, the people, they done lost their house, their car, but they just trying to seek God. But, baby, they seeking you. That don't make sense. So, you guys, I don't know if you guys know, but Valencia has a class that she does for anyone that joins her praise team. It's called School of Worship. It's free school worship. So you guys share. Because they go through all of this in School of Worship. So if you guys want to be a true worshiper, stick with us until the end. So that's good, Valencia. So there is a dress code for a praise and worship leader, and how you present yourself on stage in front of the people is very, very necessary. It's very important. Yeah. And that pities back on my motto for my business, your appearance means everything. And
absolutely.
The praise and worship is to set the house. The praise and worship sets the service. So the man of God has to come up there because he can pick up on this spirit. We won't call the spirit out, but this spirit is lusting over my worship leader. So now Valencia got more work to do because the leader is going to come to Valencia and say, well, you know, it doesn't make sense. So you guys, let's just make it make sense when we are coming before God's people, you worship leaders, okay?
That's right.
Yes. So, Valencia, the next question is, are there restrictions for women / praise and worship leaders concerning fashion?
Well, for me, I consider myself pretty young in the sense of my spirit being young, but I'm basically old school, you know. I'm not a spring chicken, but so I kind of have some old school ways.
You know, you're like under 30. I don't think you there.
You say under 30? Baby, I'm still young, honey. Trust, I'm still young. But, you know, we're from a different generation for sure. But there are some simple things that... simple restrictions that I have, not much. One is if you're on stage and if you're elevated, then your skirt needs to be, I used to say mid-calf. I still would prefer mid-calf, but it at least has to be below your knees if you're elevated, because there are people that are below you and you don't want that view or that type of situation, especially because the teams that I teach, we jump a lot. I make sure that we are really worshiping God. So you don't want to be up there trying to hold your skirt down while you're jumping and all that kind of stuff. That's unnecessary. If your skirt is too short, it's not worship friendly. There's another thing. Now, I'm a heavy girl, you know, so when we do T-shirts, the T-shirt has to at least be to your, you know, to this length, you know what I'm saying? About here, like the regular length of a T-shirt. I don't like to see things swinging during worship. Against big girls, I'm a big girl myself. But if you worshiping God and all your fat meat is going this way and that way, that's a distraction. You want to have something that keeps you
tight. It's a distraction.
Yeah, I don't like that. I don't like all the extra, you know, get your girdle on, get your body shapers on. I don't mind. Like I say, your clothing can be fitted. I don't want to see any of your body parts slinging this way and that way while we're in worship. So make sure that you are bound up good. And when you jump, everything stays in place. If you got on one of those Walmart bras or something like that, and then, you know, the straps are thin, and when you jump, stuff is popping everywhere. Come on, get some good undergarments, like the old school. Make sure you get a good bra from a good bra place. Go get measured and fitted for your bras and your girdles. And then make sure, you know, that you're bound up well in your fabrics and worship and stuff. So those are only my couple of rules. Just make sure your skirt is long enough and make sure your T-shirts are to a good length. No strapless stuff. We don't want to see underarms and armpits. And yes, cleavage. Now, people know I wears a little cleavage, but...
That is all right.
That ain't right either. That ain't right either.
Whether
it's
the next I came in this world, naked I'll return.
So the cleavage is not good either. Make sure you are covered in your cleavage area. Make sure nothing is popping out or bouncing out. Again, we don't want to be a distraction. So it's important. You can be fashionable and you can be cute without being exposed or loosey-goosey all over the place. Bind yourself up so you can worship.
Say it again. You said Lucy who?
Loosey goosey, just you know, stomach flying, everything. I got stomach, I got breasts, but I try to bind myself up. So if I'm jumping and we singing high praise, stuff ain't going everywhere. I don't want to see that, and I'm not going to show you that.
when they dress me,
they don't dress me, I dress them. They were so disobedient. See, the truth ain't been told about New Life yet, but I'm gonna tell it one day. God gonna free me up, tell you how they acted with these clothes and stuff. But yeah.
Well, you know, I got a question on here. We'll get into that. Don't run too fast, preacher.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah. Well, so So you guys, you hear that? So you touched on women. What restrictions are for males concerning praise and worship concerning fashion?
I think just for males, you got there are some worship teams that don't require movement. Again, any team I lead is a very active team.
You sing on the Valencia praise team, you're going to move. If you heal, small, whatever you are, you're going to move.
You got to move. Yeah, you got to move. I can't take that standing still looking cute stuff. So for men, you want me to make sure you have on some comfortable shoes so that your feet are not hurting. Men's feet hurt too. They may not tell you. Y'all may try to play it off, but me, y'all toes be hurting. And just like everybody else, so wear some comfortable shoes. Again, make sure your area where your genitalia is covered. Wear a long shirt if you need to. There's so much stuff you can do.
Some of the states are blessed, Valencia. You know, it's only so much that you can do.
Yeah, I don't care nothing about that. And they can't bless me, so I don't care nothing about that. All I care about is that you are covered, you know, and you are representing God well. I don't like for men to wear things that are too feminine. So make sure you are masculine because you want people to receive you.
Can you give me an example of feminine, please?
The shirt dresses that they tried to sneak in on me. They tried to sneak them shirt dresses in on me. And I was like, we not wearing no shirt dresses, you know? Because it's something else with the church and the LGBT community. And people hate to even mention it because they want to sue you or think you against them. And yeah. Listen, I'm not going to let the LGBTQ community make me choose. I'm not letting the church make me choose. I get it from both sides. You're letting them sing. They're feminine. They're homosexual. Listen, you don't know about anybody's private life. You don't know what they've said to God, if they're coming into this thing and they're repenting or they're trying to change. Don't tell me who's going to sing with me. You know, and then I don't want the community telling me what they can and cannot wear. If I say this is not appropriate, then you need to wear. If you were at a job and they gave you a uniform, you wouldn't give them no flux. So don't give me any flux either. If I say this shirt dress is gonna cause me some problems as a leader, then don't wear the shirt dress, okay? Because I'm not just dealing with you. No shirt dresses. No, just wear some. You can be fashionable without that. Don't make me have no hard time. You know, let's work together. I'm not choosing between nobody. And they're not going to tell me you can't sing, and you're not going to tell me what you're going to sing in if it's not appropriate.
Mm-hmm. That's very good.
Yeah.
So, guys, no shirt dresses.
No shirt dresses,
okay?
Mm-mm.
No shirt dresses where we're leading worship, okay?
Yeah.
No
well, period.
Guys,
don't wear them shirt dresses. Just don't wear them. You don't need them. It's too many other things to be cute in. Let me stop acting. I'm acting silly now. But yeah,
So you heard it. There are restrictions for women. Women, you shouldn't be all that, baby. Leave that for that man. Leave that for him. That's not the church. You know, get you a good bra. If Walmart is all you can afford, girl, put you some safety pins and hold them girls together and do what you have to do.
Listen, if you can't afford a good bra, inbox me. I will pay for it for you, okay? I'm not talking about nobody is having financial struggles because anybody will tell you the team that I am over, if they don't have something, I say, tell me and I'll go buy it for you. I don't put pressure on people where there's no finance. I'm not talking about you to talk about you. I'm talking about you to help you. I'm telling you to help you. So if you can't afford something as your leader and you're genuine about that, you really can't afford it, I will go and purchase it for you. Okay. We just want everybody to be able to praise God and worship God in freedom.
You guys hear, this is a leader. That's why she is crowned the GOAT of praise and worship. Where do they do that at? If you don't have it, and you have to be honest, like communication, we're talking about relationships and everything. You have to communicate. If you can't do it, you can't do it. It's not your fault, but God has, God has blessed someone that can help you along the way. Because all for God. This is all for God. So if we are doing God's work and God's ministry, how come we can't help one another?
That's right. And that's right. And now I would be less than a leader. You say what? Repeat that.
If we are doing, if we're going to do everything in decency and order, the leader most definitely should be able to help their team.
Absolutely. And I'm that leader. I'm not going to penalize anybody. If you can't afford a uniform or something, let me know and we got you. That's what family does. That's how we handle things.
And you guys that have been under leadership of Valencia, can you guys give a heart? Can I see in the comments she's a great leader? If she wasn't a great leader, let me see that too, because I want to beat you up, baby. So tell me if she was a great leader or was she a good leader? Let's give reaction. Let's give heart. Because for what I know, since I have been knowing her, she has been a great leader. Now, if she has been under great leadership, we question mark. But she has been a great leader.
My heart is genuine towards people. They sometimes folks want to say you're mean and all this. It's not about that. I'm very serious about my job. It's the same as if I came on your job, Brandon, and tried to cut up on your job. If you're in management and you have responsibility, when you're on your job, you're a different person. You know what I'm saying? You're about your business and making sure that things are in order, because there are people you are accountable to. It's the same at church. People come to church, you know, church is church to them, but we're coming to work. And there's a certain amount of order that's expected. So it's all with love and to be received in love, but there has to be order. The only people that don't get along with me are people who can't stand order. You know, and I love you. I will tell you, put your arms up. And cover your behind up, and we can go eat afterwards. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to want to go eat and hang out and laugh with you after that.
Because we don't eat after service.
That's right. But on my job, respect when I'm on my job, because you want the same respect in your management position, wouldn't you? Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Amen.
You guys, you can send all donations, all tithes and offerings, building 52, hashtag BKM and I will make sure that the profit of the house get took care of, okay? Now, if I see this cash app start going up, I'll go holler. So if I holler, that's what's happening. But that's
hilarious.
So you guys, we have to follow leadership, you guys. And with fashion, so in fashion, you guys, there is a place that you have to follow leadership. And Valencia, she has led all over the world, you guys. She has took school of worship, not only in Chicago. This is a legend that she has. And this is her passion. Like, my passion is fashion.
It is.
Your passion might be cooking. Your passion might be sewing. Your passion might be
taking care of your
children. Whatever your passion is, there is standards, and you have to be in leadership, and you have to follow leadership. If you can't follow behind somebody, baby, you will never make it.
And like you'll never leave.
It takes a village to raise a child.
And that's right. Hey, Kim. You know,
we have to make it make sense, you guys. So to piggyback on the question, you guys that are tuning in, I got to go to praise and worship on here with me. The one and only Valencia Lace. She's the only one that told the entire nation, don't clap, lift your hands.
You're hilarious.
She is great. She's great. And you guys, I need you guys to put questions in if you have praise and worship questions, questions pertaining to being a worship leader. There will be a point of the show when I'm going to ask Valencia you guys questions. Yeah. So if you guys can send the questions in, that would be great. So, you know, we don't have to go through so much looking for them. So, Valencia, the next question, will we touch base on that? We touch base on that. So let's jump to this. Valencia, how do you prepare your attire to worship if you're being an artist, or if you're leading worship, or you're featured on a program? How do you prepare your attire?
How do I prepare my attire? I just go buy new things that are the same colors and the same style for me. So I look in my closet, it's a lot of repeats of the same stuff. But I basically have a basic look for when I lead worship now. I'm going to make sure I get a chance to go to church more often where I'm not responsible, and I'll do a little different with my clothing and my attire. But for right now, my preparation is just making sure it's new or dry cleaned and ready to go. I do it the day before, as if I'm leaving The day of, you know, I try to get everything in my car for Sundays and stuff to prepare, so I'm not rushing around. And right now we're doing videotaping. So we have to bring like 3 or 4 garments at one time. So we tape like 4 services in one day. So we're singing and going to change. We're singing and going to change. That right there is hectic. But we're making it work.
Did you just see Wendell question?
What did he say?
Wendell said, how many clothes do you have on?
Wendell would be, do I have, not on. He said, how many clothes do I have? I have a lot of clothes. A lot of clothes.
I'm reading from the screen. Wendell, now you settle down because you know you one of those ones that wear those shirt dresses. So you settle down, okay?
He over here cutting up. But listen, I wanna ask you a question. Being a stylist,
okay,
and with the route that praise and worship is taking today, Black worship is kind of being styled more like CCM worship. Everybody's kind of calm and relaxed in their attire. I know at the altar, we do a lot of t-shirts and stuff like that. We'll do some things like that and, you know, your own bottom or whatever you're choosing. But we're about to do a whole photo shoot. So I want to know. What? Anyway, I want to know as a stylist, for the altar, we're about to do a photo shoot. What would you style us in where we can look individual, but still look holy and still look modern and up to today's standards of worship or fashion-wise? What would you put us in?
So we're speaking of the altar.
Since our t-shirts don't work.
So we're speaking of the altar church, correct?
Yes. Unquenchable.
Okay. So you guys.
Well, how would you style Unquenchable?
So her question, you guys, for those that are just tuning in, her question was to me, she's asking me, what would I style her church? So you guys know this is a pastor you guys see on here. She's speaking of her church and also her lovely group, Unquenchable. She asked, what would I style them in? First of all, I would need to get all y'all in one room, and I'm going to tell y'all what I'm going to take and what I'm not going to take. Secondly, I'm going to say, let's all, because you know, you got some dominant people in the altar and a Christopher. So,
only Niecy is dominant. That's the only person that Niecy is dominant.
Well, I'm going to be very low key. I almost cussed, baby. I will send her to the side. And I deal with her later. Because, baby, if y'all know, for those out there that know Niecy, baby, you know Niecy is the, baby, that's a handful, all right? And this is Niecy's auntie, you guys. This is her blood auntie. So now y'all see where Niecy get it from. Oh, y'all are catching it on the way. But, so, the question is, what would I style the Austin Church or Unquenchable in? First of all, we have to come up with a color scheme. Because I would throw out a color for the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost just to throw it in there. But there will be someone like a Valencia or a Niecy will say, I was thinking about this color. Well, we saw so-and-so in this color. So we have to first come to an agreement what the color is going to be. Everyone in Unquenchable and the altar have their own personality, which is a plus to me. Mm-hmm. So I will want to style everyone of their personality. Now, if they are a leader, meaning that they lead worship or they actually step on the front line and, well, I don't know, step on the front line, they actually get the mic and they lead. So should I say lead singer?
Yeah, that's fine.
They get the mic. Are they called lead singers? What they call?
They're worship leaders.
Okay, they're worship leaders. So they like you. Okay. Mm-hmm. So the worship leaders, I would want them to be a little more like noticeable. More so, I wouldn't try to like separate them from the background singers. But I would want the yourself and also the ones that get the front mic. I would want them to stand out a little more, but. Just me.
I'm Ricky. They knew G. Just me. Nobody else.
Very good. I love it. You said, baby. You said, I'm Valencia Lace, and this is below.
Yeah, that's I'm Ricky. That's New G. Anybody got to stand out but me? I'm kidding. I'm joking.
So just you stand out. But I would like to style everyone on their personality. We're most definitely on a color scheme. I'm not into uniforms. I hate clothes. I hate all. Right. I'm not into uniform. But my thing is, what we will do is we will come to a color scheme, and I will style everybody in their own personality. Because like you have some ladies that like to wear hats like yourself. You have some ladies that ain't got no hair. So I might need to find them a wig or maybe put them a head covering on or something. Like, you know, your niece, she's real bald head, niece. So I might need to put her on a
She gonna get you. She gonna get you.
So, you know, it's just depending on. So first of all, I would need to know the project that we're doing. I would need to know what audience are you trying to trigger. So, you know, it's a lot of homework that I would need to do before I can produce a lookbook to you guys. So I would need to know the audience you're trying to get. I would need to know, you know, when are you releasing this first? You know, so it's like those type of questions that will determine what I can put you guys in. And you guys think like, oh, stylists can be like, oh my God, I can put you in this. No, it's actually a lot of more homework that we have to do so that we can make sure that we proceed with the look and that it's not like, oh, because I would hate to put you guys in Christmas colors and you're releasing it in July.
Right.
Like, let's make it make sense. Which Valencia probably would love that. But that doesn't make sense.
No. No, we're going now for a more urban look. Our next shirts are going to say Alternation. So we're trying to reach the nations or whatever. So it's going to be very, very urban, very street. No leopard. Just urban. Some denim in there, maybe some leather in there, something that looks approachable, something that everybody can identify with, something that's comfortable to worship in. So
hold on, how to cut you off, go. So first of all, this is my live, so if I'm yelling, I'm yelling. If you would like to replay the live, you most definitely can. God bless you. What were you saying?
No, I was just saying we may hire you to style us. We just want to go for an urban feel. So, you know, be on the lookout for some urban stuff for us, you know?
Okay, I got you. You know, you can go to www.stylemebrandon.com. And, all right. You know, we can make it happen, okay?
Leather
one
is
thing
home.
I learned from my mentor is that we don't mix business. So we're going to do business. All right?
All right.
She going to cuss me out.
Now back to you.
Yeah. So that was a good question.
She's crazy.
So I don't know. I've been knowing you for so many years, but I don't know the answer to this. Have you ever had a stylist? I know that when you've been with Shekinah Glory, you know, you guys probably had someone and put your guys' outfit together. But you personally, have you ever had a stylist?
No, because I'm so stylish on my own. You know, I've never really needed one. So I just do what works. I'm joking, y'all. I am so kidding. I hope y'all know my personality. I'm kidding. No, honestly, I don't do stylists because most stylists don't consider.
So that's my next question, not to cut you off.
Yeah.
But do you think a wardrobe stylist is necessary? And why?
I do. I would love to like I say, hire you as a wardrobe stylist so that the entire team can have a cohesive look. You know, so it, like you said, each individual, I'm more so now, not more so into the colors or uniforms. I'm more so into, like I said, urban, CCM, grunge type of feel, you know, that type of thing. So I would like for you to style each person with according to their personalities, but make the look cohesive around the board. Different, but cohesive. So my only thing is for a photo shoot, I'm good for a stylist. For me doing worship, it has to be, you know, what I spoke to you about earlier, I have to be in clothing that I can worship in. So I normally style myself. But for a photo shoot, absolutely. Yeah.
For a photo shoot and also a mainstream. So, you know, if the Grammys call you and, you know, you and
the something like that. Absolutely. Yes. Style me, honey. Style me.
You said style me up, okay?
Style me up.
Yes. So that's good. So you guys heard it. I'm Valencia. She said a wardrobe stylist is very necessary. Now, she did touch base on when she's leading worship, she does like to pick what is comfortable for her because, yeah. like, she touched base at the beginning of the live. She doesn't like jiggling. She doesn't. She got some good girls, y'all. She don't like
I got some girls.
She don't like them going all over the place and stuff. So she likes to do what's comfortable for her. And you guys also know that has worked with Valencia. Y'all might rehearse one song, but on Sunday or whatever Bible class is, honey, y'all gonna do not nothing y'all rehearse. Because always
whatever the Lord says,
and she gonna do whatever she gonna do.
Yeah, whatever the Lord says.
That's good. So, so you said you haven't had a stylist, but you would like to hire one. So, but you do know how stylists work. So. Can we maybe discuss the pros and cons of having a wardrobe stylist?
Sure. You want me to tell you what the pros and cons are in my view?
Well, that's who I'm interviewing you.
Can you hear me?
I want to know how you feel about it.
How do I feel about being styled?
No, what are the pros and cons of having a wardrobe stylist? Since you've never had one, but what have you heard? You've been in the industry, darling. You know the pros and cons. So let's talk about it. You know, I like to be real.
I think in my case, and I have similar issues with photographers or people that do video, knowing how to style or how to photograph or how to video all different body types. And I feel like some people know how to style a certain body type and that's what they're good at. But when it comes to heavier women or heavier men or different body types, sometimes the angles that photographers or video people use is not good for a heavy person. And sometimes those who style us don't take into consideration that we are not the average person. We have extra meat in important places where it shouldn't be. So
but that's it's really important for some place.
Well, yes, but it's still the garment still has to fit the body type. You know, somebody as slender as yourself. Yeah, somebody as slender as yourself has. And somebody as slender as yourself has to take into consideration when somebody has two or three stomachs. You can't always stick a belt up in wherever you want to stick it, and you can't always choose pants that's going to come up to the waist and all this extra meat is hanging down. Like, you have to be mindful to know how to camouflage and style a heavy person where they still look nice, because there's nothing worse than being put in something that you're not comfortable in and then it looks bad too. Now, I'll be uncomfortable if it looks good, but you know what I'm saying? I can't have both. Can't do both.
Not both. So, you guys, give Valencia some hearts. You guys are just tuning in. My next question is, you guys, that wasn't all early, you guys know Valencia is a parent of two now. She's a single mom, and she deserved the Parent of the Year award. She is doing a great, great job with these two lovely stars that she had. So, being that you are a single parent now, how are you keeping up with the latest fashion for kids?
Oh, this pandemic won't let us be great. Now, I know we can online shop, but I don't like online shopping. I like to see what I'm getting in fabric, unless I know the brand. You know, like I pretty much trust Baby Gap and all things. But some of the stuff that's on Amazon and online. Yeah, I'm having a hard time during the pandemic, but normally when I can get out to the stores and get to what I want to get to, I've been loving my kids are so cute. I'm not even trying to be funny. My kids are extremely cute. So whatever I put on them, they're gonna look cute. But I go shopping for them practically every week. So their fashions are gonna be Pinterest worthy as soon as I can get out the house and get to some better stores. You know, that as soon as the stores are really open, they're going to have a lot more stuff, too. But before the pandemic, yeah, we were up with the fashion.
Yeah. Y'all, because let me say something, because baby sis would come out in a gown and a tutu.
Yeah. Sis loves to dress. She loves to dress.
So, before the pandemic, it was nothing to play with. So, I'm like, what? So, you said baby, like that?
Hold on, honey. My whole stand just fell. Okay, we back.
Now,
go ahead.
Now slips. Now she got a fatal later. Okay.
Lord have mercy.
You guys let pray. Let's pray to God properly come to you, Lord. Touch the God of praise and worship right now.
This is
on the Don't let our kids be the Lord. Don't let our kids
be the Lord. Sis, making a mockery. Sis, go sit down. Go step on the bed. She done spilled all my drink. Y'all been seeing under my skirt, Lord Jesus. All right, okay. We back. Now, what's the question?
So, are you ready to go out to the next question? Because they not playing us be great.
Go ahead, sit. Go sit down.
Single mom. So you guys see a single mom, the golden crazy birthday. She got two babies, and baby, they say, honey, you been talking to this slim guy a little too long for us, okay?
Talking to who?
Oh, you've been talking to
this
slim guy a little too
long. Yeah, let's wrap it up because my kids are tuning up. So it's time to go, honey.
So, Valencia, what do you miss about fasting back in the day when you were growing up compared to what fashion is now?
What do I miss about fashion back in the day?
When you were growing up compared to where fashion is today?
Well, honestly, the only thing I miss about fashion is this thing. Is the 70s clothes. I'm a 70s baby. So
yes, you are, girl.
Yeah, I'm a 70s baby. So I miss the bell bottoms and stuff like that. I did not like 80s fashion. Wasn't that crazy about 90s, but I do love the 70s. I just have a love for it. But other than that, not too much. I think fashion where it is right now is pretty good, and it's more individualistic, you know, and it's not matchy-matchy. It allows your personality to show through. So I'm very happy with where fashion is right now. Yeah.
That's good. So
and the rules are changing.
I'm gonna throw questions in together. So what is your favorite store? What is your favorite store to shop at, and what is your favorite brand for yourself?
My favorite store to shop at, honestly, for heavier women, they're not doing. The boutiques are probably our best choice. There's a lot of black owned boutiques that are pretty good, but like Curve Culture, they were pretty good, but some of those are closed down now.
Okay.
Torrid, you know, I used to love Torrid. It was way more gothic back in the day. Now it's doing something different. Lane Bryant, Ashley Stewart, all those stores, don't care for them anymore. They're not really representing plus size women well. But my favorite brands, now honestly, this might not be the expensive stuff for y'all, but I'm in love with anything Steve Madden. I like the way he makes his shoes. I like his backpacks and purses and things like that. I love Steve Madden. I'm really kind of basic. I love anything that's a Lucky brand. I love Lucky. That's one of my favorite things. What else? I love any brand that has something cute for a plus size girl. If they have something cute, I'm going to shop it. But yeah, right now, there's somebody needs to come out with some better stuff for heavier women. Waiting on that brand to come. Yeah. But I got Gucci, but I'm not a Gucci girl. I'm not that label type of girl, even though I have some of that stuff. I just have it for the sake of having it. It's not really mine. You know me. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. If it's cute to me and it's in Walmart, I'm going to wear it. And I'm going to wear it like it's, you know. What's that? It's a meme out that says a chick that knows fashion or a woman that knows fashion can shop in a thrift store and outdress anybody that's wearing all labels. You know what I'm saying? It's how you put it together. It's what you do, and it's how you carry yourself and how you present yourself when you wear it. Because they talk about me. Ooh, what you got on, honey? All this is gorgeous.
Do you say what? It's kind of window says show him your Gucci. He never seen it.
Boy, my Gucci costs more than your whole apartment. Don't even try it. Don't get me. They be cutting up on these lives. Don't get me started. Yeah, I have Gucci, honey.
So, but my thing is, you might be basic with clothes, but one thing, honey, she ain't basic about it. It's coming to hair and that face, baby. So we were actually at a previous church that Valencia was the worship leader at. The service was over, and we were in the back, and her and one of the other worship leaders had to do it. And she told the worship leader, you can use all the pack in your hair, girl. It's okay. You can use the whole pack. She said,
I'm like, what are you talking about? Sit down. I'm like, what are you talking about? You talking about, go ahead and say her name.
No, don't say her name. So one thing you guys know, Valencia used all her makeup and she used her whole pack of hair, baby.
I use all my bundles. Yeah, I hope y'all know all this was in fun. Like, I want y'all thinking I'm sitting here, I got Gucci. I'm not that girl. I'm very down to earth, and I like to have fun. So we just having fun.
You guys. This is just making make sense. This is only good vibes only. We're going through a pandemic, so why not laugh a little?
Mm-hmm.
So, Valencia, let's get personal. Let's see. Valencia, what is your favorite song that you have led or recorded, and why?
My favorite song? I don't know. That's a hard question, Brandon.
Well, give me a hard answer.
My favorite song.
What is your favorite song you have led or recorded?
That's hard for worship songs because I have so many favorite songs.
Okay, how about this? If you're not going to answer, I got something for you. So either you answer okay. or you take this ticket.
Okay.
Which one you want? You want this ticket or you going to answer?
A ticket? What ticket?
I'm finna give you, either you going to answer the question or you going to do what I'm finna tell you to do.
I'm answering the question. My favorite song, I think my favorite song to do is the clap shout medley. I love the energy of yeah, clap your hands, all ye people. I like the energy of that song. So yeah,
back your part. Shout out to God. Clap your hands. Yes. So my favorite song that you have recorded is Yes. Yes. Open your mouth. Yes. Can you give me a little of it? Just 2 seconds. Yes.
Yeah. No. No, I don't sing on live.
Yes. Say,
not gonna happen.
Jesus. So you told Jesus you're gonna bang your soul, baby. I'm the man right now. Oh, baby.
Are you comparing you and Jesus?
No.
Not going to happen tonight, no. But
so
you can go
good.
On YouTube.
That's real good. So, you guys, her favorite song to lead is The Shout. It's a melody that she came up with. You guys know Valencia is known for taking somebody's song, making it her own, baby.
And, yeah.
And, baby, she was gone and... Yeah, she would go and switch it all up, baby, and lay the people out, baby. This the only thing that can take a hymn and make it into worship, baby, and enslave the leader, the church, the ushers, the dogs, the people out there working that aren't supposed to be getting slayed. Baby, she does it. This is what she does. It's her heart. And when it's up to you, you see your heart, baby. Ooh, y'all set me up. Yes. Because I never want to leave this place.
Hallelujah.
Yes! Thank you, Lord. Which one of your colleagues do you look up to when it comes to leading worship?
Sis. My colleagues do I look up to when it comes to leading worship? I think my niece is probably my favorite worship leader. She is anointed, she is skillful, and she's spontaneous. I love her prophetic flow. I can relax when she has the microphone because I know I'm about to go in. I'm a big fan of everybody that has that I work with, Monica. Now my little sister, honey, she will take you there.
Yes, Tila. She will.
Yeah, like all Wendell. Yeah, who else am I missing? Yeah, I'm just a fan of all of them. I enjoy their worship. I really do. So
she's named, these are people that have sat under you and you have made them great. Not only God, you know, you played a big role in them. And everyone that she named are recording artists. They are on major platforms, and that's good. But Valencia, I never want to leave this place.
I want to say they're all great. They're all skillful in their own right. I had to do a lot of work with Wendell. You know, he needed a lot of work. So I took a lot of time with him. So whatever you
sing
for
him right
now.
Because, you know, Wendell don't fast sing at Broadway. Wendell get out of
that
stage like he at Broadway.
I'm kidding. I'm just messing with Wendell. But yeah, go ahead. I'm just acting a fool. Go ahead.
That's good. So, Valencia, which one of your gospel peers is leading the way in fashion today?
Let me tell you, Sister Tamala, man.
Ain't she snatched?
Her and these hips and she's a very shapely, pretty girl. And I love her fashion choices, whoever styles her, but she's not difficult to style. She's not heavy in the stomach area. She's just hippie and busty. And that's always something easier to style than somebody that has no butt and, you know, boobs and stomach. But yeah, Tamala is doing an awesome job fashion-wise. Who else? I like a lot of what Kiara does too.
God bless.
She does some nice things, huh?
Yes, so Tamaland and
Sierra. Yeah, I like what they're doing, yeah.
Yes, I love it. That's good. Well, you know, Tamala said she didn't come to play. She had that surgery, and she said,
honey,
she said, y'all take me as I am. Yes,
she let us have it. Yeah.
So,
Mary. I didn't mean to lead them out. They have led fashion for me in gospel for years. Mary, and Gugu, on point.
Yes. Plus size girls. What they call them, BBWs?
Yeah. BBW.
Yes. So that's good. So Valencia, let's step outside of the gospel industry. Name an artist, okay, a reality star, an actor, a celebrity that is inspiring you in fashion outside of the gospel industry.
Okay.
Nicki Minaj.
Outside of the gospel industry that inspires me. And, you know, Gwen Stefani, is that her name? Gwen Stefani? She can do no wrong in my book.
Gwen, okay.
She can do no wrong in my book. I love her fashion. She can't do too much that I don't like. Actually, I'm a Kardashian fan, so I'm not gonna say new Kim, but the mid Kim, not when she first started, but mid Kim was awesome, and I like Kylie stuff too. Yeah,
that's good. You're like Beyonce, Cardi B.
Beyonce?
Cardi B?
kind of out of my age generation. Yeah, look, just a little too short. Beyonce's worn some cute stuff, though. Don't get me wrong. My Beyonce has had some very cute stuff on. Cardi B may not be my style so much, but bless her heart. You know, she spent $400,000 on her baby's birthday party. I was like, Jesus. Did you hear about that?
Yeah, well, that's what you're gonna do for your baby's birthday party, Asia.
Not no 4K for no baby, honey. Not no 400K. Not unless that baby name.
That baby name sure is.
Honey, not unless the baby name is Michael Jackson Jr. Ain't gonna be no 400K party. Well, Kylie Jenner can spend that kind of money. She's a billionaire. She can spend that kind of money on a party, but you know, be careful coming up because you never know what tomorrow holds. People are funny and finicky. They're, you know, praise you today and knock you down tomorrow. You're looking for a job. So, I you know, everybody got to watch them finances early on.
So, you guys.
But go ahead, Cardi.
So, you guys, this has been great, you guys. We are coming to an end. You guys know who I am. I am Brandon Moment, better known as Style Me Brandon. You guys can find me on all social media platforms at Style Me Brandon. My website is www.stylemebrandon.com. You guys, I got this, the praise and worship GOAT on here with me, y'all. Nobody can do it like this. Nobody. This is the only lady in America that has told the people to... don't clap, lift your hands. Now, how you gonna tell me in my front room, don't clap, to lift my hands? But that's what she did. And let me tell you something, everyone followed the lead. But Valencia, she doesn't get praised and honored enough. So I thought that it would be only so great that I would bring someone that has been faithful to me, you guys. I have known her. I met her through her niece. And when I tell you she has been faithful, she has always remained the same. She get me together, and she pieced me together. She has been there. For those that don't know, I was on my deathbed. She was there with soul food. The doctor said, you can't bring that in there. She said, this is for me. And she put it in my mouth, and she has been faithful, guys. So you guys have to find you someone that is faithful and loving. And Valencia has showed herself all of the above. Valencia, can you tell the people where they can find you at? Tell the people what you got going on next.
Yes, you can find us at 6620 South King Drive at the New Beginning Church. That is also where we hold our altar, church of worship, school of worship, services, and classes. So you can find us there. At the altar, the last Sunday of the month, we start back in August. So the last Sunday in August, we'll be there. We're not open to the public or audience yet, but we will be doing a taping that you guys will be able to see via social media outlets. So that's where we are. If you need classes, training, vocal technique, praise and worship leaders training, you can always hit me in the inbox and we can set you up with some classes, whatever you might need. Yeah.
That's good, Valencia. Can you tell them your social media, is your website and everything, so they can find you at?
Oh, you can find me on Facebook under Valencia Lacey, also Valencia Lacey 2. No, Valencia Lacey Continued. That's what it is. So my first page is Valencia Lacey. My second Facebook page is Valencia Lacey Continued. My Instagram is the Valencia to Come. So please hit me on Instagram. We want to get our Instagram. So find me on Instagram. And that's about it for the most part. That's mainly where we do most of our networking.
Yes. So you guys, this has been great. Valencia is going to close you guys out with encouraging words. I want to let you guys know, thank you so much for coming in. You guys, tune in next week at 5 o'clock. I have the Ad-Lib Queen, Lady Diane Williams, will be on here with me. She's going to be discussing fashion. Back in the days, you know, she's old soul, but she is the only Ad-Lib Queen that we have. And she will be on here front and center discussing. You know, she's a fashionista with her bun on. And she told you,
baby, yeah,
work it out if you let her. So you guys, tune in next week. Valencia, can we close out? You know what we're going through. Do you mind just giving the people an encouraging word so that they can keep on pressing on during this pandemic to see what the end's going to be?
Yeah, I just want everybody to be encouraged. I know sometimes it gets difficult. I've gone through my situations with just being at home, especially being at home with two small children and no adults to really talk to. It's a lot to take care of them, manage my household, still work. But be encouraged. This is temporary. I don't believe we're going back to a normal, but I do believe God is going to give us a new type of normal where we can survive, thrive, and where we can kind of get used to it. This is so out of our element. I realize that, especially those who are hard churchgoers like me. We go to church and work, and that's about it. So I understand the transition, but God is faithful. And I know some of you know, like I know, that this season has been a season of provision. Some of us have way more than we've ever had. Some are having more than they had before the pandemic. So God has been still been being a provider. So be encouraged. Hold your head up. Use this time of isolation as a time of getting closer and drawing nearer to God. There's something he wants to say and something he wants to do in this season if you listen. This time is the time that's getting us away from the excuses. If God was to come back right now, we have no excuse not to be ready because we've had enough time to get our stuff right with him. Occupy until he comes and draw closer to him while we wait. Love y'all.
Love you too. You guys tune in next week. Lady Diane Williams at 5 o'clock. Valencia, let's shout.
Where you getting that from? Mwah. Love y'all. It was fun. Thank you. Hey, Cherie. Hey.